Glasgow in Scotland, a country with a proud warrior tradition. In July 2003, Glasgow hosted a world championship. The World Kendo Championships are held once every 3 years. Kendo, the way of the sword. Once unknown in the West, it now has 3 million devotees worldwide. More than 500 sword-wielding men and women, called Kenshi, have assembled here to put their years of training to the test. Facing their onslaught is Japan, guarding its birthright as the foremost kendo nation. There have been 11 previous world championships, all won by Japan. This time, the Japan team's captain is 35-year-old Naoki Eiga. At under 5'6", a small-framed but powerful Kenshi. He bears the heavy responsibility of representing Kendo's mother country. Eiga's duty is to show the world the essence of Kendo. To prepare for that challenge, indeed that ordeal, he has been working on developing the spiritual and mental strength needed to stay calm in any situation.
If you're preoccupied with the result, you lose the mental freedom you need to win. I'm looking for a technique that's possible only when the mind is focused but free, detached.
Eiga is determined to win. But to win, he must achieve a state of mind where winning doesn't matter. This is no frivolous mind game. Eiga has to find a way to defeat the best Kenshi in the world. On July 4th, the 12th World Kendo Championships get underway. The 3 days of competition will involve contestants from 41 nations and regions. Kendo was introduced overseas by emigrants from Japan. More and more people around the world became devoted practitioners, intrigued by Bushido, the spirit of the samurai. The first world championships were held 33 years ago. Outside Japan, many Kenshi excel in physique and strength, and their skills have been improving rapidly. Will this be the first tournament in which Japan tastes defeat? Or will Japan maintain its superiority through the strength of tradition? That is the question everyone's asking. Britain, whose tradition of chivalry dates back to the Middle Ages, has shown keen interest in Japanese kendo. Even the Queen and her husband make an appearance at the competition. In the men's team competition, Japan is under intense pressure. In team kendo, 5 Kenshi fight consecutive bouts. In the past 2 men's finals, Japan has won by a single bout. Team coach Masahiro Miyazaki tells the Japanese Kenshi to expect a hard-fought contest this year as well. More than just winning is at stake. Japan's performance is expected to set the standard.
映画。はい。
Eiga is the captain of the five-man team, the last to fight. So he is Japan's bottom line. It's a heavy responsibility. July 6th, 9 a.m. The men's team competition has begun. To become champions, the team must win six matches, beginning with the preliminary heats. Japan's opponent in the preliminaries is France. Right from the start, they're up against strong opposition. France is ranked in Europe's top two. Each bout lasts 5 minutes. The winner is whichever first scores 2 points or has a 1 point lead when the 5 minutes are up. 1 point is called ippon. To score an ippon, the kenshi must strike one of four specified places on his opponent's body. A strike to the head called men. A strike to the right wrist called kote. A strike to the flank called do. And finally, a thrust to the throat, tsuki. Against France, all four of Eiga's teammates have already won their bouts when their captain takes the floor. There is one more important condition for scoring an ippon. If a strike to one of the designated parts of the body is judged to be a fluke or only a light touch, it doesn't count. Unless the strike shows good sword control, poise and fighting spirit, it won't be recognized as an ippon. It's just over 3 minutes into the final bout. Eiga's opponent's feet have stopped moving. With a dashing pair of consecutive kote and men strikes to wrist and head, Eiga claims the bout. The score is 5-0, a whitewash for Japan. Clapping his hands, his opponent sportingly acknowledges Eiga's technique. To score an ippon, you must show the will to overwhelm your opponent. That is why kendo focuses on training the mind. A demanding day has begun. Japan's kenshi will have to exert themselves to the limit in one match after another. The Japanese team was selected in March. The announcement followed a training session held in Chiba, near Tokyo. Japan held six training camps altogether, more than ever before. This was a measure of the team's determination to win and of the growing strength of the global opposition.
I thought we'd be late. We only just made it onto the train in time.
For the past 20 years, opinion in the world's kendo community has been divided over whether kendo should become an Olympic sport. Japan has opposed it, fearing that kendo will be caught up in the medal-winning frenzy and victory will become the sole object. In their training, the team is also coached on match etiquette, which reinforces the importance of learning from one's opponent. This attitude is fundamental to kendo.
Kondo wa 15 do. 15 do re. Hai. Aite ni taisuru re. Aite ni taisuru re wa kanazu aite no me o mirakuchi. Aite no me o mite rei wo suru. Tatoeba shiai no toki, keiko no toki demo相手の目を見て心の底からお願いしますという気持ちがない。特に世界大会。
A kendo proverb says, strike and reflect, be struck and give thanks. Discovering and overcoming one's own weaknesses increases mental strength. That is considered more important than winning or losing.
一本目
But that philosophy would carry a lot less weight if Japan were easily defeated in the World Championships. To uphold the national traditions of kendo, Japan's team members are expected to win every time. At 35, Eiga is the oldest member of the team. Over long years of punishing training, he has picked up a string of injuries. He's had operations on his right elbow and left wrist. Recently, his knee has started giving him problems.
I go beyond my limits, and that takes its toll. At any rate, it ends up causing me pain. Today my wrist hurts. And when it hurts in one place, the pain starts spreading to other places too.
Eiga works as a police officer, attached to the riot police in Hokkaido, northern Japan. For more than 10 years, he's lived two parallel lives, patrolling the streets and doing disaster relief work, while also competing at the top level of kendo. This is the fourth time Eiga has taken part in the World Championships. At one time, though, he thought about retiring from the national team. The reason? He thought that he had already fulfilled the dream he'd been chasing through kendo.
これで原田を破りまして、映画直樹は初めての決勝進出になります。過去この全日本47回の歴史の中で、
In November 2000, Eiga faced the reigning king of kendo in the final of the All Japan Kendo Championships.
いかにこの宮崎の6回という数字が素晴らしいものかお分かりいただけるかと思います。その宮崎に挑む映画直樹。
Eiga's opponent was Masahiro Miyazaki, 4 years his senior, the winner of a record 6 championships.
左赤が宮崎、右白が映画。さあ5分間の決勝勝負が始まりました。
The final would decide whether Eiga would become champion for the first time, or Miyazaki would be the first man to claim 3 consecutive titles. A legendary Kenshi seeking to confirm his supremacy, up against a late bloomer in his first final at the age of 33. Eiga's instinctive kote strike wins him the All Japan title. Immediately after that victory in 2000, Eiga was invited to join the national kendo squad as it began preparing for the World Championships in Glasgow. Being on the squad would mean frequent call-ups for training camps and matches, a life consumed by kendo for another 3 years. It would mean less time with his family, the risk of injury, and also the heavy burden of upholding the honor of his country. He agonized over the decision.
Well, I don't know if it's pressure exactly, but I am expected to win every time. And not only that, but also to represent the excellence of kendo before the world. When you have to win, when you're fighting, and the difference between winning and losing hangs by a thread, 100% success is impossible. There's always 1% you can't control, and that 1% is scary.
But after some serious soul searching, Eiga decided to set his sights on the World Championships. Precisely because the challenge was so great, he felt he could not back down.
Give up once, and soon you'll give up twice, then three times. I can't give up now. This is my life after all. Turn back, keep going, it's my life, and I prefer to keep going.
In the men's team competition at the World Championships, Japan has beaten France, the Dutch Caribbean territory of Aruba, and Chinese Taipei to reach the last eight. Determined to overcome Japan, the other teams have come up with all kinds of strategies. To get the best from their kenchi, many have hired Japanese coaches. The Germans are banking on physical strength and size to win with a power kendo style. Training under a Japanese coach has lifted their confidence.
We know that Japan is very strong, and Korea also. And of course we try to also defeat them and want to gain the first place.
In the last two championships, Japan had to fend off tough challenges from South Korea, winning by only a single match. This time, not only are the Korean kenchi tall, 6 foot or more, but they've also been using new training methods. They introduced Zen meditation into their 36 training camps to improve concentration. Team manager Hak Jin Park is satisfied with the outcome.
검도는 체력으로 하는 게 아니고 마음으로 정신으로 하는 운동이기 때문에 그러한 말씀은 조금 앞으로 좀 삼가했으면 좋겠고 우리 나름대로의 자존심이 있는 거고 그래서 그래서 지금까지 훈련 우리 대표선수 훈련을 좀 극한 훈련도 많이 했고 그런데 극한 훈련을 좀 배제하고 그 정신 훈련 자기 자신을 이길 수 있는 그러한 그 마음 훈련을 상당히 많이
One member of the Korean team stands out for strength and skill. He is Kyungnam Kim, 38 years old, who is also the team's coach. For 20 years, he has dominated Korean kendo and has never lost to a Japanese kenchi in the team competition. It was rumored that in this tournament, he would be the captain. But he didn't even appear in the competition until the final eight. Was this a ploy aimed at defeating Japan? His absence was ominous. In the quarterfinals, Japan beat Spain and has advanced to the semis. There they meet Italy, which defeated Brazil, third placed in the previous championships. Eiga is the only member of the Japanese team to have won every match without conceding a single ippon to an opponent. Captaining Japan is a heavy burden in itself. Eiga has decided to focus on dismissing the desire to win from his mind. Against Italy, Eiga chalks up another superb win with two ippons. If you cannot overcome the desire to win, you cannot strike a telling blow. Until Eiga learned that lesson, he suffered through a long spell when he was obsessed only with pursuing victory. The 1997 World Kendo Championships were held in Kyoto. Eiga appeared in the team competition for the first time. But he only fought one match in the preliminary heats. In the knockout phase, he was just a substitute. Eiga had really worked to be in top condition for his last championships while still in his 20s. Being sidelined was humiliating, a denial of his value as a competitor.
I only competed in the preliminaries, so even though the Japan team won, I was only half glad and half frustrated and upset with myself. That night, after our victory celebration, I went back to the hotel where my wife and parents were staying. Around midnight, and for about half an hour, I just cried, sitting there with my family.
Eiga felt the team didn't believe in him, and the only way to change their minds was to win. First, he set his sights on becoming the All-Japan Kendo champion.
さあ、注目の試合です。
審判員は主審の千葉、
左赤宮崎、川本、右白が映画。宮
沢で行います。
In 1999, the year before he claimed the title, Eiga met the king of Kendo, Miyazaki, in the quarterfinals.
そうですね。これはもうまさに決勝戦に近い試合じゃないかと思いますですね。
In that tournament, Eiga was betting on a technique he had practiced to counter Miyazaki's signature men strike. Three minutes and 10 seconds into the bout, Eiga countered Miyazaki's men with a do, just as he had planned.
Miyazaki got it.
But the judges awarded the match to Miyazaki. Eiga was dumbfounded. The three judges considered Miyazaki's men strike, launched a fraction of a second before Eiga's answering do, to have been the winning ippon. That single ippon transformed the way that Eiga thought about winning.
I thought I'd drawn him out and struck a door against him. But the judges said he got a men. How could that be, I wondered. How come he got that men? So I watched the video at home. And even I could see when I watched the NHK broadcast that it was his men. What happened? I asked myself. I practiced my door counter to Miyazaki's famous men strike, lured him in and struck. And yet he beat me with the decisive men. It wasn't that he was expecting my door counter, but in that decisive moment, he moved in with a clear mind and total commitment. My own move was calculated and considered. That was the difference.
There was something lacking in Eiga's kendo. To discover what it was, he began going to the dojo at 7 o'clock every morning when no one else was around. He decided to go right back to the basics, to when he first took up kendo, and to rethink his whole approach. He started by cleaning the floors. To clear his mind, he polished the floor of the dojo's practice hall for 30 minutes every day. Gradually, he began to understand where he was going wrong.
I was totally obsessed with winning. And because of that, I couldn't move instinctively. I was blocking my own instincts, holding them back. I was driven by some strange desire. That was what I had to overcome. I needed to work on something else. My spiritual and mental strength. That was my problem, the challenge I faced.
The desire to win, the fear of defeat. Eiga focused everything on one thought, the single blow.
決勝も延長に入りました。向こう側3連覇7回目の優勝を狙う宮崎正弘、手前白初優勝を狙う北海道の映画直樹。
1 year later, Eiga faced Miyazaki again. In the 8th minute of overtime, he launched an unexpected move. In an instant, he avoided Miyazaki's men and countered with a kote. Eiga knew that this was what he'd been looking for.
It wasn't a move I thought about. I couldn't do it now. But that was the ultimate kendo technique, the perfect blow.
At the moment Miyazaki had rushed into his men attack, Eiga had unconsciously but quickly drawn back his left foot. This slight retreat allowed him to evade the men, and in the next instant, his defense changed into attack. Pivoting on his left foot, he repositioned his body and struck a kote in the brief moment of opportunity. Ah! Cote's strike was a reflex, the body reacting instinctively. That ippon confirmed that Eiga was the man to captain Japan's kendo team. Four in the afternoon of July 6th, the time for the men's team final has come at last. So far, the five members of Japan's team have notched up 22 wins and three draws. But one team has an even better record, Korea, with 23 wins and two draws.
The final of the 12th World Kendo Championships.
The last two finals were between the two rival countries. In both cases, the outcome was decided by the final bout between the captains. As expected, Korea is captained by Kyungnam Kim. The first bout begins. It's a virtual deadlock, with a lot of close contact fighting until the 3 minute 11 second mark. Japan's Taramoto lands a do strike to give Japan the lead. In response, the Korean team simply fights harder. After a draw in the second bout comes the pivotal third bout. Korea's Park evens the match count with a men strike. The fourth bout between the vice captains is another draw. Once again, the championship rides on the clash of the captains. If Eiga loses, Japan's unbroken string of titles will come to an end, and Korea will realize its dream of victory. The 5 minute bout between the captains begins. Kim stands over 6 feet tall. Eiga, at under 5'6", cannot reach him unless he throws his whole body into attack. Kim is also blindingly quick, able to strike at will from a distance or close in. The two Kenshi, one tall and the other short, dance between defense and attack. The 5 minute bout ends without a winning strike. For the first time in the competition's history, the match must be decided by a playoff. Each team will nominate a member to represent them. Eiga made a promise that he would give all he's got at these championships. That promise was to the children he teaches once a month at a small neighborhood dojo in Hokkaido. Eiga himself took up kendo in his first year of primary school. He wants to pass on to these children the lessons kendo has taught him. When he's training with the children, Eiga doesn't hold back. He wants them to learn never to flinch from a blow, even in practice. He feels it's important to face adversity. That's why he decided to contest the World Kendo Championships despite his injuries.
Great, thank you very much. The only thing now is to be bolder, be more daring, give it everything you've got when you strike. The rest was good, thank you. You have to beat your opponent. But first, I think, you have to defeat yourself. To defeat yourself, you have to fight pain, pressure, and hardship. To do the right thing is tremendously difficult and demanding. But that's what I've tried to do. And whatever the kids may think of it, I really want to get that idea across to them. That's what I work for.
In the playoff, there's no time limit. It's sudden death. Whoever scores the first ippon is the winner. All Korea's hopes are riding on their captain, Kim. The hall is silent, except for the tense clicking of the bamboo swords. Have gone by. The key moment comes just after Kim has parried Eiga's sword and recovered his stance. Seizing his opportunity, Eiga lands a one-handed tsuki. It's a brilliant, audacious move. Eiga and his fellow team members claim Japan's 12th consecutive World Kendo crown. It's been 2.5 years since Eiga agonized over whether to join the Japanese team. Now he has reached the end of his journey.
Well, thank goodness that's over. We all had tough matches. Thank goodness.
Eger has made his point to the world. Don't give in to adversity. The ultimate battle is with yourself. He has conquered his desire to win, and his reward is victory. It all came down to a single blow.